I am the referee. I spoke to you in the dressing rooms. Obey my command at all times. You both know the rules. Watch them heads and kick them punches up. When I shout break, you break clean. And remember, defend yourself at all times. Shake hands.
Good luck too to referee Ian John Lewis, and congratulations to him. It's his first fight as a star class referee after a 7-year apprenticeship. The full-time detention officer at Chatham Police Station. I know all his mates at the police station are watching to see how he performs tonight. First round then, the black trunks of challenger Harry Dhami from Kent and the tartan of the Irishman from Leeds, Derek Roche, making his third defence of the British welterweight title. And the last one was an absolute stormer against Scott Dixon. Dixon down three times and Roche twice before Roche prevailed. Roche is a puncher. Can Dhami take his power? He's usually very resilient. Dhami has to box on the outside, Glenn.
He does, with that height and that reach. He's got to try and use the jab well. He's got to keep outside and not get involved in a brawl with Roche. That's where Roche will want to be, and that'll suit him. Dhami, quite wiry and unorthodox, you know, can make life hard for Roche, but he's got to stay at long range.
Mustn't leave that chin out to dry either. Dhami's very tall. It's an inviting target for that left hook. Good right hand from Dhami in there. It's a little bit of a swelling on the forehead of Roche. He's trying to get a closer look at that. See that, Glenn, just by the left eye? And something on the cheekbone as well.
Yes, just above the left eye, there's a little circular bump appeared, and also a bump on his cheekbone. So already punches of Dhami having a little bit of effect to the face of Roche.
Right hand, a clubbing shot. Big support for Roche in here, by the way. He sold 300 tickets himself. Is Dhami good enough as a boxer to keep him away for 12 rounds, as he surely must do? He's a rough handle. The heads came dangerously close together there. Roche really dived in.
Dhami's boxed at a lesser level. He really needs to rise to this challenge.
Even light hitters have had Roche on the floor, though. That's interesting. He's been floored 7 times in his career. Not many unbeaten champions carry that kind of statistic around with them. It's part of what makes him exciting, though.
Big roundhouse right hand landing there from Roche. He's desperate to get close to Dhami.
Good right hand from Dhami. Roche looking for these big, wild, haymaking right hands. He's missed with them so far, but he didn't miss with that left hook. No shortage of action in this first round. Metrodome, which is packed tonight for this fight. I'll tell you what impressed me about Dhami in that round. He took a couple of good punches and without flinching.
Yes, he was quite cool under pressure, and that's one thing he's going to have to be, because Roche is going to exert a lot of pressure.
I think that little clash of heads might have caused that swelling we were talking about. This is round two. Black trunks, Harry Dhami from Gravesend in Kent. Trying to dominate behind his jab. He's going to need all his durability. He's only really suffered one questionable knockdown in his career. Hardly counts at all. But Roche does hit.
Well, the jab is going to be an important punch for Dhami. He needs to use that to keep Roche off balance. And it's whether he can use that punch effectively and not be caught as he's thinking about it.
Dhami was telling me that thus far in his career, he's never really been able to prepare properly for a fight. For this one, he's had 6 weeks off work, his factory work, and he says he'll be 50% better than he's ever been before. need to be. Roche's own preparations, 10 weeks of it and only one day off. He means business too, had a good long rest after that grueling fight with Scott Dixon. He's the kind of fighter who somehow always seems to find a way to prevail.
Yes, he is. He's just lunging in a little bit too much at the start. And he's got to be careful he doesn't walk onto the punches of Dhami and increase their effectiveness.
Dhami looking for the long jabs and to whip in the occasional right hand. Roche just a little wild by comparison early on. Dhami starting an 11-4 against underdog with the bookmakers this morning.
Roche needs a bit of lateral movement. He's coming straight on to Dhami and then straight back out. He needs to come in with a few angles. He'll show something different to Dhami.
He's coming in straight lines, Roche. Dhami's composure so far looks good, though. Roche must believe by now that with his power, he can turn most arguments around. But he might need some boxing skills too here, otherwise there's the danger of falling behind on the scorecard. Definitely boxer v brawler here, isn't it?
Very much so.
The old classic mix.
And Dhami can't afford to get drawn into a brawl. He's got to try and keep it on the outside and then tie Roche up in close.
I've given both rounds to Dhami so far.
Live international football matches for you on Wednesday night. Sky Sports 2, 5:30, early start time. Yugoslavia under-21s against England. Big game for both countries. At 7 o'clock, full international, Scotland-France, live on Sky Sports 1, live and interactive only on Sky Sports Extra. Roche Dhami for the British welterweight title.
And this is the third round. So far, so good for Harry Dhami, the underdog and challenger. Roche will be looking, I fancy, more and more for the shots, don't you, Glenn?
Yes, he's got to find a way in first to get close enough to land the body punches, and that's the difficulty for him, because it's a long jab that Dhami's throwing, so he needs to, you know, step up to the sides, do something different to get the punches to the body and the head.
The effect of body shots, if Roche could land them, would be to slow up Dhami. Roche's career to date has been a good success story for an unsung northern stable. Can he take it on here tonight, though? Hasn't found keeping the title easy. Tough one with Georgie Smith. Very tough one with Scott Dixon.
That was better from Roche. Got inside, started trying to get the hands working, get a combination going. Picking up, son.
Both of these two men, bet on it, have come in fantastic condition. Tribute to their preparation and their training teams. Right hand, and Ian John Lewis says he was asleep, but it's being counted as a knockdown. Now the first big decision of Ian John Lewis's career as a star-class referee is a controversial one, because he scores that as a knockdown.
Well, Roger's got a cut left eye, just above the eye.
So it's all happening here in the third round. Is that a turning point? Dhami has got to get that out of his head and get back to his boxing again. Damage left eye, Roche, just to underline that. So maybe the two kind of level each other up. More Roche's kind of fight though in this round. He's getting closer.
Well, he really has to get closer. He's got to try and work Dhami when he gets inside. He's really got to rough him up, get him out of his stride, and just get him involved in the brawl. And that's where Roche can get his punches on.
needs to be ice cool, Dhami, to keep it confident and composed from the outside. That's good from Dhami there. Well, it'll be scored as Roche's round because of the knockdown. It was counted as a knockdown, but was it a genuine one? Now let's have a look at it again. Glenn, what do you think?
Well, he lands a body shot. I mean, he didn't trip over with the feet. He did actually hit him with a punch. It wasn't a good punch, but he did hit him with a punch.
I thought it looked fair enough on that evidence.
Yeah, I think it was. You know, there was he didn't trip up, he didn't slip on anything. He didn't push him over. He landed two shots, one, to the body and the chest, and they were enough to put Dhami over.
So that's another knockdown that he will question. There was a similar kind of thing to that earlier in his career. He's not badly hurt, but that might be going down as a 10-8 round for Roche, maybe crucially on the scorecard. But I think you have to say that Ian John Lewis got that spot on, despite the protest of Dhami. It's the fourth now, Dhami in black. Roche's preparations, by the way, included 16 rounds of hard sparring with Ricky Hatton, and there's a great right hand, no doubt about this one, from Dhami. Roche on the floor yet again. Good shot.
It was a good shot. Short right hand, it really wouldn't be a fight with Roche in if he wasn't on the floor.
So here we go again in another Derek Roche British title fight. Both guys have been on the floor already. We're only in the fourth. What next?
That will give Dhami confidence. He knows he can hurt Roche, knows he can put him on the floor. So he'll start to gain a little bit of confidence in his punching now.
The eye damage for Roche is not serious, not yet. Nothing much more than a scraze. Great noise around the arena, thunderous in fact. Dhami's got a few fans here too, including his family, the brothers anyway. Those punches really do travel a long way of Roche, don't they?
Yes, he lets them go. That was better from Roche, getting close enough to get a body shot on.
The extra experience at this kind of level for Roche might be important too here. Dhami in at this level in a 12-rounder for the first time. Roche kind of knows what it takes by now. He's been there before. He's the more battle-hardened of the two. Don't think he was badly shaken up despite being on the floor.
Well, Dhami's still keeping cool, using the jab, trying to punch it at long range.
Trying to give it a bit of lateral movement and another right hand. Puts Roche down for the second time in the round. Well, well, well. And he goes down until the count gets to 8. Maybe that hurt him a little more than we thought, Glenn.
Well, I think it must have, because there was another good punch from Dhami, and Roche, you got to see, in all sorts of trouble now.
Real turnout for the book in the fourth round. That's a 10-7 round for Dhami, I think. Two knockdowns.
Well, I'd have to agree, 10-7. Just hits him on the side of the head, very disorientating, that punch. He gets up pretty quick, but it obviously hurt him. And it was a good little short right hand, just a straight punch, but very effective, and the feet just went from under him.
A think the second one might have hurt him a bit more than the first. And the telltale sign was that he went back down on his haunches, didn't he, to take the full eight count.
Yes, he did. He didn't really know what to do. He went back to a neutral corner. He doesn't have to do that. Just the fighter that puts his opponent down. But he went back to the neutral corner. Then he went down on one knee. So I think he was disorientated by the punch.
Landed right on the top of the head. Fifth round. There have been three knockdowns in the last two rounds here. There have been some good fights for this title over the last few years. Thinking back to that Kevin Lucian, Chris Saunders thriller. And the one between Roche and Dixon, of course. Fifth round, Dhami in the black trunks. Jab and move tactics from Dhami. Has to be the right strategy.
Well, he can afford to do that. He can afford to use his height and reach, build up the point all the time, looking for Roche to commit himself and then bring that short little chopping right hand into play.
Big right hand again, and this time Roche took the shot. It was very similar to the one that had him down in the last round. Roche gets there himself with a right hand. You just don't know what's going to happen next here, do you?
I certainly don't, especially when Roche can be hurt and he was hit by another good right hand, just leaving his chin open on that left side. And Dhami nice and accurate with his punch.
Good footwork too from Dhami there. This is a man who once lost four fights in a row too. But since moving down properly to welterweight, he's unbeaten. Roche though knows he has the equalizer with his power. It's a good body shot from him there, Glenn.
Yes, there was. Roche has to get inside and work when he's inside. He's only really managing to land single punches. He needs to start getting combinations going. And it's difficult with Dhami's footwork, with his range, with his good jab, for Roche to be able to do that.
Growing in confidence, you fancy, Dhami. He's not exactly unhittable. He took a right hand there.
Again, Roach landing with the right hand, just trying to get closer.
Does it a couple of times as well. He's come back a little in the second half of the round, Roach. Not much in this one, Ben.
No, this one's pretty close. Dhami not as effective, and Roach getting closer to him.
Back to the Barnsley Metrodome. Will it turn into the Pleasure Dome tonight for Harry Dhami?
Well, he's got to be full of confidence at this point. You know, he's had some good success. But Roach, gutsy as ever, he'll still try and close the gap down, get his punches on. He's been on the floor before. He's used to that. You can't write him off yet.
Round six of the British welterweight title, as won by the likes of John H. Tracy, Colin Jones, Lloyd Hannigan, Kirkland Lang, Gary Jacobs. Not to mention Ted Kidd Lewis, who wasn't half bad in his era.
Yeah, he'd have been half bad in any era.
Good right hand from Roach. Dhami in trouble, big trouble, needs to hold on. Roach, is this the moment for him? Long time left in the round. Head needs to clear. He was badly shaken up. How much has that taken out of him? He somehow has to now get through, what is it, 2.25 minutes.
Well, he needs to use movement, he needs to use that jab, keeping his hands up, not allow Roach to get too close.
This is a bit of a crisis for Dhami. Every second counts for him now to let his head clear. Let the life come back into the legs. Oh, and another right hand was a big shot. He rather walked onto it, Dhami. Just a little careless. He just rather staggered for a moment too on the far side. He's looking more open. Roche is getting close. This doesn't look good for Dhami at the moment, Glenn.
No, it doesn't. It looks much better for Roche. He'll have got some confidence from that. He's getting closer. The boxing of Dhami just going to pieces a little bit. He's got to try and clear that head, get moving again, get Roche on the end of that jab.
Did he just get a little overconfident? Did he go to sleep on Roche right at the start of the round? Maybe. Did his concentration waver? Roche, very good left hand to the body as well. Now for Dhami, who takes another big right hand, very big right hand, and he's needing his resilience now, but he looks open. Roche is getting to him now. Big round in the fight, this one, maybe the pivotal round.
Well, he's looking tired, Dhami. His defences are coming down, leaving himself open to Roche's hooks.
Blood from the nose of Roche, but that doesn't seem to matter. Cracking right hand from Dhami, though. And now Roche is hurt. He was hurt by that shot. This is some round, this. Roche was hurt too. This time he doesn't visit the canvas. But it's Dhami, I fancy, who needs the minute break the most. They need to get it back together in that corner with him. He needs that minute. They need him back there quickly. Terry Tool with his back to in the red. And Brian Hill is the main man, the main trainer. Tool is the manager. He's unbeaten since he joined him.
Well, it was a bad round for Dhami. Big right hand from Roche, just putting him in trouble there. Really just walking onto that one a little bit with his hand down, just left the jab out there.
I'll tell you something, not many people could take a punch like that from Roche at domestic level and stay upright.
Well, he's got a good chin, it's been proved that, Dhami, but he needed that resilience to get through that. That was a good right hand, he was hurt later in the round as well. But he's tough, he's resilient, and he's very game, Harry Dhami.
Say what you like about this Derek Roche, he's in some cracking fights. Tartan trunks, remember, with the tattoo on his back. Derek Roche from Leeds, but also from New Ross County, Wexford. He left there when he was 2 months old, but goes back occasionally to a hero's welcome. Was a minute long enough for Dhami. Good right hand from him. Roche seems to want to hold on there in close. Well, both these men, we now know, can really hurt the other. And a right hand puts Roche down again. He claims it's a rabbit punch. Ian John Lewis is having none of that and says authentic knockdown. Roche down for the third time in the fight.
Well, that punch was on the side of the head, towards the back of the head a little bit, but it just shows you that those punches around the side of the head do disorientate Derek Roche. They do upset him.
So what a comeback from Dhami. Well, you could subtitle this a Tales of the Unexpected. A fight that is twisting and turning all over the place. This time from Roche, his supporters off their feet in the arena. Ian John Lewis, the referee, won't forget his first big one, will he? Now, that didn't seem to be much contact there, but down goes Roche again.
Well, again, that was a punch on the top of the head. and really having trouble with those sort of shots. Dhami can deliver them because he's so tall. Roche ducking down, and the punches anywhere around the head are giving him all sorts of trouble.
Just seemed to skim the top of the head, didn't it, that shot? But it was enough. He's found twice in the round and four times in the fight, the champion. The blood just trickles through a little from his left eye. But he doesn't look badly shaken. Oh, and now Dhami. Maybe just lost his balance more than anything. But you'd need to be Mystic Meg to work out what's going to happen next here.
Well, this is an exciting fight, one way then the other. Both capable of hurting each other and both doing it round after round.
It really is a good one. Well, two knockdowns for Dhami in that round with those right hands that have worked so well for him.
Well, it was just there on the top to the side of the head, and he's complaining that it was at the back. And that one just skimmed on right at the top of the head. But they are giving Roach trouble. They're coming from up high. He's crouching down under them. And Dhami has no option but to hit him on the top of the head.
I'll tell you something, though. Amid all this, we've got to make sense of the scorecard somehow. All these 10-8s and 10-7 rounds. I've got Dhami 4 points ahead at this point.
Well, I've got Dhami 2 points ahead. I didn't think he'd won it well enough for a 10-7 round. I give that one 10-8.
This is the eighth round. We're in danger of losing count of those as well. That's Glenn's scorecard. I've got it wider for Dhami, but I gave him the first two and Glenn didn't.
Good right hand from Dhami there, and the right uppercut just catching Roach as he comes in.
Could go either way this. Right, apart from the knockdowns, Dhami, it's what you like really. Do you like his jab and move style and occasional right hand, or do you like the bustling pressure of Roach and the body shots?
Well, there's a lace loose for Derek Roach. He's just got to go to the corner and get that fastened.
So it's just as well that happened, because there's not been enough drama really, has there? Without that, we needed something like that, didn't we?
Well, the crowd are enjoying this one.
A paraglider's going to arrive in the ring any minute. It's that kind of night here. Once again, a British Championship fight provides us with some storming action. It happens a lot.
Roach holding! Fight!
Well, Derek Roach is certainly good value. He likes a bit of drama.
Well, he was saying he doesn't like easy fights. It's a kind of madness, but he likes to be tested. He likes these wild affairs. And to that extent, he's yet another throwback type, isn't he?
Well, nobody ever said boxers were seeing.
And knowing you, we know that to be true.
Thanks.
Dhami all the time now is looking to whip in those overhand rights, landing around the side, top of the head of Roach. He knows how damaging they can be. Couple of left hooks, but then Roach just looking a little unsteady on his feet as Dhami landed. And another right hand, and down goes Roach for the fifth time.
Well, it's that same punch every time, that choppy little right hand catches him just on the top side of the head, and Roach goes down on his knees again.
Well, what an amazing thing it would be if Derek Roach, having visited the canvas five times and counting, held on to his title here. It could easily happen, the way things are moving.
Well, it could happen, but Dhami have more and more success, building in confidence, letting that right hand go more and more.
And he's beginning to pick off Roach on the way in. which of course doubles the effect and of the power of the shot. With Roche walking onto it, he's got to be very careful about that. Amazing stuff here in Barnsley. Roche could turn it around again with his power. Into the Derek Roche corner. Is everything all right in there? You wonder what is the nature of that discussion. They're complaining about the shots around the back of the head, the rabbit punches, but I don't know, the phrase tilting at windmills comes into mind a bit.
The problem that he's got is, you see there, being shorter, he's dipping his head down, so it's really Roach's fault. You know, Dhami's got nowhere else to hit him, he's got to hit him there.
And here's round nine in this fight, which seemingly has a knockdown almost every round.
Now another lace, I think.
Oh dear. Second time in the fight. Well, I suppose if I was a bit of a cynic, I'd say
no.
Nah. They're buying a bit of time.
No.
No, I don't think so, do you?
No, I don't think so.
No, I don't think so. Of course not.
Never be cynical in this game, yeah.
Of course not. But I'll be a bit worried in the Roche corner, trainer Kevin Spratt, the former light welterweight in there, and supervises training at Bradford's Route 1 gym. That's where Roche does his work. Good display this by Dhami. What an effort he's put up, and he'll kick himself if he doesn't go away with the title tonight. But there's still work to be done. Roach is ever dangerous. There's the right hand again. This was a heavy looking shot, but this time Roach absorbed it, and there's a low blow this time from Dhami. Whatever next here?
Well, that was amazing, because Roach got hit full on the chin with a big heavy right hand. He took that one, and then little ones on the top of the head are sending him down.
He's in trouble from this low blow. Well, I think there was an indication from the referee there that he might have kneed him.
Well, it was difficult to see from where we were, because we were behind him. His knee did come up. I didn't think it had connected with him, but obviously it did.
Something sure connected. Looking at him.
Well, it wasn't a ref. Him, John Lewis, didn't do anything.
Keep your eye on him. Crikey, what a night he's having in his first big fight. The referee here. He might go another 10 years before he gets another one like this.
Again, that chopping right from Dhami. This time Roche takes it.
Good jab from Dhami, trying to keep Roche at arm's length, and then whipping those right hands. There's another one, and he again just seemed a little unsteady as it landed. Right cross from Dhami, definitely the superior technician, well, by miles actually.
Yes, he is. He's just, because of the styles, the clash of styles, you know, it's not really shooting Roche. It's too difficult, the height disadvantage, these choppy right hands, him being short. You know, he just can't get away in, and he's come forward in straight lines too much. He needed more angles.
Dhami getting the better of the argument, I fancy, in this round too at the moment. With the knockdowns, I've got him in a big lead on my card now, Dhami. His dad is in India at the moment and will be making a phone call home to Kent tonight to find out whether his son is British champion. The news could be good at the moment anyway. But really, you still wouldn't want to call this, would you?
You wouldn't. It's difficult for Roach. It's hard for him to get in. Then when he does get in, Dhami, long and gangly, wiry, can tie Roach up.
Now then, let's look at this low blow incident. Was there a knee involved at all?
No, it was a little right hand. He did get caught with the right hand, but there certainly wasn't a knee. Just watch the right hand, and there it goes. Well south. It was very, very low, that. That one was quite high. That was a big hooking overhand right, which has given Derek Roach so much trouble throughout this fight. And I've got him in a big lead now.
Five points
ahead.
I've got it 7 points, because I gave Dhami the first two rounds.
You also scored a 10-7 round where I just had a 10-8 round.
Yeah, but that was because there were two knockdowns, so just following the guidelines. So I could see your argument, Glenn. Always difficult, these things. Goodness knows what the referee's card is saying. Here's the 10th round. 9 minutes to go in this crazy seesaw fight for the British Welterweight Championship. Roach might still rescue it. Oh, he's in trouble now, Dhami. Seemed to trip a little bit, but a punch caught him as well. And again, there's a long time left in the round.
Another good right hand, just to the top side of the head, making the knees dip of Roach.
Strange thing, if he lands the right to the jaw, Roach seems okay. If it's around the top or side of the head, he's often visiting the claw. I have to say, he does look a little low on punch resistance, Roach, but he can hit himself, and he's got Dhami darting around the ropes again.
But Dhami's got to keep cool, keep to his boxing, corner forward, even at this late stage, to get involved with a brawl with Roach.
Roach has to gamble now. He'll try to just walk through anything that Dhami has, including the risk of taking more of those right hands in the hope of landing some big shots of his own. Looks a little unsteady on his legs at the moment, Dhami. Took a few early on in the round, and I fancy he's going through a difficult period here, Glenn.
I think he is, because he's forgetting his boxing. He's standing too much here with Roach, and this is where it's very dangerous.
Can Dhami last out the full championship 12-round distance? That is a slip. That is not a knockdown.
A little by Dhami, a little bit of time. Just if he is feeling uneasy, just to settle his head.
Takes far too many shots, doesn't he, Roach, really?
Yes, he does. It's the way he fights, the way he comes in. No, he's not technical. He looks to have a brawl.
You wouldn't think it's a career that could have much longevity, being in contests like this every time.
Both of them getting tired, both of them missing quite a bit in this round.
It may be a question of which of them lasts the distance better. We know Roach can do it, can Dhami do it? He's giving out one or two little distress signals, I'd say, in this round.
Well, this is a much better round for Roach.
His gloves are beginning to come down of Dhami's. He's leaving his chin out to dry a bit.
I think the problem is he's getting very, very tired. He's finding it difficult to keep his boxing together.
Well, coming up, the longest 6 minutes of his life, I reckon, Harry Dhami. Certainly of his boxing life.
Well, there's a bad swelling above his right eye as well, Dhami. That's making his vision a little difficult. But that was better for Roach, just putting pressure on Dhami. Dhami's scrambling around, getting caught with shots. His defences have come down, he's leaving himself open, and he's getting tired. This is a dangerous time for Harry Dhami.
And he's moving into new territory now. He's done 10 rounds three times before, and one on each occasion against Paul Dyer, Alan Gray, Kevin McCarthy. But can he go 12 against a hitter like Roach, who will be going for broke now?
And also at the speed that this fight's been fought at, you know, there's been a lot going on. He could be very tired, Dhami.
This is where that extra preparation that he was doing, the 6 weeks off work, the proper authentic championship preparation, just might pay, though, for Dhami. He'll be glad that he did it now. The 7 miles of running every day. Has he freshened up again? Roche has to win everything from here on in, I think, to even make an argument of it on the scorecard. But he could come up with a knockout punch. He's done it before.
Well, Terry Toole, Brian Hill, very experienced in the Dhami corner. I'm sure they'll have told the man, start boxing, use that jab, don't get involved. We're nearly there.
So far has done this with a judicious mix of left jabs and right hands and combinations and slick boxing. But all the time, Roach is looking to pressure him. He's had to come through a few crises in there as well, Dhami. Showed his heart, character, desire. Can he close the show, as they say now?
Well, he's lifted himself after that minute's rest and he's got a little bounce in his step. Just needs to keep putting that jab out.
Right hand from Roche, who's just looking to load up with some heavy shots. A left to the body was a good one, and then a right to the body. They may take more out of Dhami, who wishes the finishing line was closer than 2 furlongs away. It's a good fight, this. Absolutely packed with incident. Sorry, Glenn.
Dhami doing the right thing, but then Roach lands a big right hand.
Keep your eye on the clock, too. Top left of the picture. 40 seconds left in the round. How much has Roach got left? Can he lift himself?
Well, really, in this round, he needed to push Dhami more than he has. He's obviously feeling the effects.
Dhami's done pretty well in this round so far. Roach has had the odd success, but for me in this round, Dhami's superior boxing is winning him the second at the moment. Agree, Glenn?
Yes, I do agree. It's been good. They've sent him out with the right instructions in the corner, and he's carried it through quite well.
Well, 3 minutes left in this remarkable and extraordinary fight. Roach's face is a mess. Punches landed. Dhami 1-3-3. Roach 1-3-2, but that takes no account of the knockdowns, which have to be built into the scorecards.
Yes, that's different. It's round by round scoring, how you judge your fight, and that obviously they're both doing a lot of work, both landing a lot. But for me, Dhami well ahead.
Roach has been scheduled for 12 rounds on 4 occasions. Dhami never. Dhami obviously has never completed 12. Roach has done it a couple of times. Glenn's scorecard says this.
5 points in the lead for Harry Dhami and just one round to go.
I have it 7 for Dhami. So we both agree that Roach needs a knockout.
Most definitely, and I'm sure he feels he needs a knockout.
Otherwise,
we'll be going all out to get one.
Otherwise, we have the upset here tonight. Not many people fancy Dhami to do this, and Roach could still pull it out of the fire. Left hook from Roach. He needs a success early in the round, doesn't he? Needs to get Dhami going early.
Yes, he needs to hit him and everything go from Dhami and then pile the pressure on. But he's got to be aware of the right hand of Dhami, which has bothered him throughout this fight.
Good right hand from Roach. Big shot, his corner waving him in. But is his British welterweight title reign in its last couple of minutes now? There's another big right hand and a left hook.
Well, that's the wrong tactics for Dhami. He's got to keep out of the way of that right hand. Again, he's trying desperately with that right hand. Derry Roach, he's got to try and find the target with that.
Right hand goes in from Roach. A minute and now 10 seconds to go, 70 seconds. Is this the crowning night for Harry Dhami? Will he become the first Indian to win the title? Roach is trying to throw in everything, but he's fighting almost on instinct now. I fancy they both are. They have put on an absolute thriller here for the British welterweight crown.
Well, it's a better finish from Roach, just the fresher of the two. He's still landing with a big punch, not as much coming from Dhami.
But Roach has been on the floor five times in this fight. Dhami just the once, or did I lose count and miss one somewhere?
Well, they're both tired, they're both missing with punches. Dhami close to the finishing line from what you'd expect to be a champion.
Dhami has been boxing since he was 9 years old. Some thought him lucky to get this chance. And now, would you believe it, with seconds to go, they've got to do up the tape on the glove. Well, I'm not sure that was that much of a problem, to be honest with you, at this late stage. There's the bell that ends it. Dhami's got it! Harry Dhami becomes the first boxer of Indian ancestry to win a British championship, and he right well deserved it too. It was a terrific performance. He had to come through crises to do it. But he was a good winner. And it was a very, very good performance from him.
Yes, it was. He really boxed to a game plan. He did it well. He worked behind the jab every time Roach came in. He caught him with that short little right hand. That was the key punch. That was something Roach couldn't get out of the way of. And he rightly deserved it. Big winner. Roach, for his credit, tried so hard to find the punches, but just couldn't do it.
Let's join our MC John McDonald, see what the margin was.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, referee Ian John Lewis would like to congratulate both boxers on a very, very hard-fought contest. His scorecard reads, for Roach, 109 points. For Dhami, 116 points. Your winner and the new British welterweight champion from Gravesend in Kent, Harry Dhami.
The margin was 7 points, that tallied with my scorecard. Well done to Harry Dhami. We'll talk to both boxers right after the break.
Upset. Harry Dhami is the new British welterweight champion, and although it was on points, he had the outgoing champion Derek Roach down five times. Fantastic fight. Here is the winner with Adam Smith.
Well, Harry, it's a dream come true for you, but what a battle to go through it.
He's a true champion, and I'm glad he never vacated it before I fought him, because, like I said, well, I knew it was my time. He was a good champion, like I said, this is my era now.
You told us at the weigh-in that you would have the style to beat him, and that's what it was, wasn't it?
Yes, I stuck to my game plan, but I never boxed as good as I could, though. But it was a learning experience in there for me, anyway.
He's a hard, hard man, isn't he? He gets up.
Oh, mate, I tell you what, a true heart of a champion, heart of a champion. He never let it go easy. Battled me all the way through to 12 rounds.
And your father's out in India. Are you going to call him now?
Oh, there's going to be one big party out there. This is to the Asian community as well, and the people back home in Gravesend. I'm bringing it back home, people. I'm bringing it back home.
Congratulations, Harry, and enjoy it.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thanks, Sky.
Special ringside. In fact, it